Let's talk about the path of how close we are to the NerveGear of SAO. The crazy thing is that it is already possible to read signals that are coming directly from the brain. And this can be done by something that we call an EEG. This stands short for the word electroencephalography. Now this might sound very difficult, but it's basically a bunch of electrodes that are being put around someone's head. And by doing so, it could read the signals from the brain itself. That would mean if I see a piece of fruit and I recognize it as a banana, this EEG could then actually read those signals and translate them to know that I'm looking at a banana. So it's basically reading your mind. The crazy thing is that this technology has already been used for many years, especially in the medical field, to diagnose patients that have a problem that is located in the brain. But besides just reading your mind, it could also send these signals back to the computer. And this is what we called a BCI, which stands short for a brain-computer interface. Let's take the previous example, where I see a piece of fruit and I recognize it as a banana. Now in my mind, I think about picking up that banana and eating it. By using this EEG and brain-computer interface, they can read these signals from my brain and directly send them to the computer, which then could make my avatar in virtual reality start eating that exact banana. With the crazy part being that I actually never ate that banana in the first place. I was just thinking about it. And that is exactly like we see in Sword Art Online. That means it is already possible to control our virtual reality characters by just using our brains. And there are many companies that are already trying to integrate this into virtual reality headsets. There is, however, one problem with this, and that is the precision. Now, the building blocks of the brain are what we call neurons. And there are billions and billions of neurons inside your brain alone. Now, the problem with this EEG is that it cannot read the brain on individual neurons. Instead, it reads a group of neurons together. To explain it in an example, is that we can easily make our characters walk forward, jump, or pick up an object. It becomes much more difficult to do very precise tasks. Taking the example from before again, with the banana, picking up the banana and eating it would be easy to read with this EEG. However, if I wanted to peel that banana with just two fingers, this would be much more difficult. Luckily, because this technology has been out for many years, it's getting more and more advanced every single day. And it's crazy to think it is already possible today to control our characters in virtual reality by just using our thoughts. But however, besides just reading the signals, the NerveGear from Sword Art Online also sends signals directly back to the brain as well. And because of this, you could just be laying on your bed while the headset sends signals to your brain to stimulate all your senses so that you can see, hear, smell, taste, and even touch the virtual world without having to move a single muscle. Now, could we also achieve this in real life right now? The only problem is that sending signals to the brain turns out to be a lot harder than reading them in the first place. This is because of the exact same reason that we had before, and that is to send signals to the brain, you will have to be even more precise. Because if you're in Sword Art Online, you don't want to have a blurry vision or hear things that are not actually there. Luckily, there have been many companies working on this exact problem, and one of the most famous examples is Neuralink, which is owned by the big man called Elon Musk. And recently, Neuralink came with some crazy breakthroughs in where they were actually able to both read and send signals to the brain directly with the precision of the level of a single neuron. And that is exactly what we would want for Sword Art Online. However, once again, there is one single problem. The way Neuralink achieved this is by putting the chip directly into the brain. Because if you would have to put it outside of the brain, it would also have to go through the skin and the skull. But by putting it directly inside the brain, it could stimulate it directly. And this is of course a huge achievement. But it would of course be even better if we could manage this without needing tons of brain surgery. Just imagine the VR headset like the Oculus Quest 2, but then with an included EEG like we talked about before. Now how this would work is that we can overcome the hurdle of sending signals directly to the brain. Because we can still stimulate our senses by using the headset itself. The most important senses like vision, hearing, and even touch with all the VR gloves popping out here and there can be completely stimulated by just using the headset right now. And the EEG could then at the same time read your brain waves. This would mean that you could just lay on your bed like an SAO and control your character with just your thoughts. At the same time, you will be looking at a screen that stimulates your vision, listening to the audio from the headset to stimulate your hearing, and feeling VR with haptic feedback coming back to you from gloves or the headset itself. And all of this can be done without needing to send any signals to the brain or any implants at all. And best of all, it is technology we have already today. Now with this hybrid setup, you also don't have to lay down on your bed. You can also still choose to move around and use it like a normal VR headset. It is just that it has the option of completely being integrated like a Fulldive nerve gear and without the dangers of your body being shut down. There are also companies that are trying to create this exact idea right now. Think for example about Valve, who are also the makers of the VR headset called the Valve Index. They have been working on creating a headset that also has an EEG built into it. Besides Valve, there are many companies that are trying to become the first one to achieve this as well. And if you are just as excited as I am about Sword Art Online in real life, then make sure you show it by completely destroying that subscribe button.